Let us deal with this name, Jehovah Witnesses. They will tell you anytime they come in contact with you. You ask them a question, why do you call yourselves Jehovah Witnesses? Why do you say you are a Jehovah Witness? And the first scripture they're going to take you to is Isaiah chapter 43 and verse number 10. This is why we call ourselves Jehovah Witnesses. But remember, church, when one wants to understand a body of scripture, you must understand the context of the scripture, who's being spoken to, who's talking, and what the context of the scripture is talking about. Jehovah Witnesses will tell their listeners that they'll tell us to read Isaiah 43 and verse number 10. However, we need to find out who the Lord was talking to. I want you all to turn back to Isaiah chapter 43, and we're going to read in verse number 1. Notice what the Bible says over there in Isaiah 43 and verse number 1, because the Bible explains itself as to who it's talking to. Isaiah 43 and verse number 1, the Bible says, "But now, thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel." Now see, the Bible tells us it's Israel who he is talking to. The Lord wasn't talking about you today, and he didn't tell them to call themselves Jehovah Witnesses. Because if that was true, then the Israelites would be called Jehovah Witnesses. And we can read about that in the Old Testament, where the Bible would tell us that the Israelites were called not only Israelites, but Jehovah Witnesses. That's not all, church. Let us eliminate the name altogether. Turn with me to Isaiah chapter 65 and start at verse number 1. And we're going to notice in God's story, what did he say he would do to this rebellious people when they go against him? Isaiah 65, starting in verse number 1. Notice what the Bible says here. The Bible says, I was sought by those who did not ask for me. Now he's talking about the Gentiles. I was found by those who did not seek me. I said, here I am, here I am, to a nation that was not called by my name. Now who was called by his name in that day? It was the Israelites. But there were a people who were searching for him and who wanted to find him and who was trying to do his will. And he says, this nation was not called by my name. Notice verse number 2. He says, I have stretched out my hands all day long to a rebellious people. Now who was that rebellious people? It was the Israelites. They were very rebellious against God. He says, who walk in a way that is not good according to their own thoughts. It was the Israelites who were doing things according to their own thoughts, their own ways, and their own deeds. Notice verse number 3. A people who provoke me to anger continually to my face, God says, who sacrifice in the garden and burn incense on the altar of bricks, who sit among the graves and spend the night in the tombs, who eat swine's flesh and the broth of abomination, things is in their vessels. Notice verse 5. Who say, keep to yourself, do not come near me, for I am holier than you. These are smoke in my nostrils, a fire that burns all the day. Drop down to verse 14. The Bible says, behold, my servants shall sing for joy of heart, but you shall cry for sorrow of heart and wail for grief of spirit. You shall leave your name as a curse to my chosen, for the Lord God will slay you and call his servants by what? Another name. So it eliminates the name Israelites. It eliminates the whole name that the Jehovah Witnesses are trying to call themselves. It eliminates that name. The Bible says it's going to slay it. And they want to call themselves by a name that God says is going to slay.